This video will show you how and when to scout sweet corn for European corn borer, fall armyworm, and corn earworm. I will also briefly review other pests and beneficial insects of sweet corn. We will be using the sweet corn IPM scouting form that can be downloaded from the sweet corn blog by going to this link. It may be helpful if you take a few minutes to print out a copy of this form before we begin. At the top of the form, you will fill out the date, time, grower's name, and the field that you are scouting. You will then select the growth stage of the corn. The growth stage will determine the threshold used while scouting. Definitions of growth stage can be found at the bottom of the form, as well as definitions for other abbreviations used on this form. Depending on whether the field you are scouting is pre-silk or silking will dictate whether to use a 15% threshold or a 5% threshold and the associated columns to use in making a management decision. Before we begin, let's review the three major pests that we will be scouting for: European corn borer, fall armyworm, and corn earworm. European corn borer adult moths are reddish-brown to yellowish in color and have two dark serrated lines running along the edge of the forewing. Eggs are laid in clusters of 15 to 35, often on the underside of leaves. The eggs overlap like fish scales and will hatch in about 5 days depending on the temperature. Larvae are gray to pink in color with brown spots on each segment and a brown head. Mature larvae will be up to an inch in length. European corn borer damage can be recognized by the shot hole damage larvae cause when feeding in the whorl. They can also bore into the tassel, causing them to turn brown and break. Larvae will also feed within the stalk and ear. Fall armyworm adults have a white mark at the tip of the wing, a white diagonal line across the center of the wing, and a yellow spot located near this line. Eggs can be found anywhere on the plant. They are laid in clusters of 100 to 200 and are covered with scales and hairs from the female moth. Eggs will hatch in about 5 days, again depending on the temperatures. Larvae are tan, green, or nearly black. The distinguishing feature of the larvae is the inverted white Y on their head. Mature larvae are up to 1.5 inches in length. Larvae will feed on the leaves, resulting in a ragged appearance. Large amounts of frass can often be found below the feeding site. They will also feed on the ear, but usually burrow through the husk to get to the ear, unlike corn earworm that enters through the silk. The final moth we will cover is corn earworm. The adults are yellowish tan to brown in color. They have two dark spots on each forewing, and the live moths will have green eyes. Eggs are laid singly on fresh corn silk. The eggs are very small and difficult to see. They hatch in 2 to 10 days, depending on temperatures. Larvae are light green, pinkish brown, or nearly black, with dark lines running the length of the body. They have a tan head and are about 1.5 inches in length. Larvae feed on silks initially, then move down into the ear. Damage can be seen in the tip of the ear, which will often contain large amounts of fecal material. They are cannibalistic, so usually only a few larvae will be found per ear. In addition to these three larval pests, there is also space on the form for other pests, including corn leaf aphids, corn flea beetles, and rust. For corn leaf aphids, you will want to scout at tassel emergence and use a threshold of 50% of the plants with more than 20 corn leaf aphids per tassel. Beneficial insects that will feed on moth eggs, aphids, and other pests can also be indicated on the form, like lady beetles, syrphids, lacewings, and pirate bugs. Now that we know what insects and damage to look for, let's decide how to scout a cornfield. To properly scout a cornfield, we want to get a representative sample of the entire field. This is best done by walking through the field in a V or W-shaped pattern, stopping to scout periodically. Be sure to select plants at random and ensure that all representative parts of the field are scouted. This scouting form is designed to be used for pre-silk corn, where the threshold will be 15%, or silking corn, where the threshold drops to 5%. You will systematically walk through the field, scouting for European corn borer, fall armyworm, and corn earworm larvae. You will also look for egg masses and check the plant for any signs of damage. You will look at 5 adjacent corn plants and mark down the total number of plants that showed any damage, eggs, or larvae. Also note number of flea beetles, number of plants with greater than 20 corn leaf aphids, and number of leaves with rust, as well as number of beneficial insects observed. Here I will take you through an example of scouting pre-silking corn where the action threshold will be 50% or greater. We will start at one end of our cornfield and begin walking in a V-shaped pattern. we will scout 5 consecutive corn plants within one row. The individual corn plants are depicted in this graphic as the 5 squares within the pink box. Let's scout these first 5 corn plants. The corn we are scouting in this example is an early tassel. You will want to begin scouting your corn just before tassels appear and continue scouting 1 to 2 times a week until harvest. Pay close attention to the tassel. Look down into the whorl for any signs of feeding damage such as broken tassels. You may also see frass or actual larvae. Thoroughly check the leaves for any signs of damage, frass, or larvae. Also keep an eye out for any egg masses. The first 3 plants have shown no signs of damage. However, the 4th plant that we come to has feeding damage on the leaves. And when looking at the tassel, damage can be seen as 2 dark spots on the tassel. To examine the tassel more closely, it can be removed from the whorl. This reveals even more feeding damage, as well as a young European corn borer larva. So looking at the 5th plant, we also find no damage or larvae. So we now have looked at our first set of 5 plants, and only one has had damage or larvae. The damaged plant is depicted here with the blue box. We will write this down next to the first set of 5 plants. The total for this set of 5 plants is 1, and that will be marked in the total column. The RT is the running total, and that is also 1 for now. No other pests or beneficials were seen, so we will mark down zeros. You will then move on to the next 5 plants, following the V-shaped pattern described earlier. Let's say you find no damage, larvae, or eggs on any of these next 5 plants. You will mark down zeros. And your total for this set of 5 plants will also be 0. However, the running total will be 1 due to the previous 5 plants. Move on to the next set of 5 plants. This time you have 2 plants with damage or larvae. One plant had a European corn borer larva, and a separate plant had damage. The total for this set of 5 plants is 2, and the running total for all 15 plants is now 3. Since we are scouting pre-silk corn, we will use the first 2 columns to determine if action is necessary or if we should keep scouting. The ND on the form stands for no decision, meaning you have not scouted enough plants to come to a decision on whether to treat or not. Moving on to the 4th set of 5 plants, we again find no damage or larvae. And your 5th set of 5 plants is also all zeros. So your running total is 3 plants with damage. Looking over at the decision column, you cannot yet make a decision on whether to treat or not. Your running total is 3. A decision could only be made at this point if your running total were 7 or greater, in which case you would know that 15% threshold was reached. Since your running total is still below 7, you will need to continue scouting. So move on to the next set of 5 plants, numbers 26 to 30. In these 5 plants, 2 have damage or larvae. You have 1 with a larva and damage, and 1 additional one with damage. This brings the running total to 5 plants. Too high to decide a treatment isn't necessary. If you had 0 plants or 1 plant with damage at this point, you could stop scouting because you are below threshold. But 5 is also too low to warrant a treatment. Had you reached 8 at this point, you could stop scouting, knowing the threshold was met. Instead, you will continue to scout. The next set of 5 plants has 2 damaged plants. Now we are at 7 as a running total, still between 1 and 9, so we'll continue to scout. Our next set is plants 36 to 40. 2 of these plants show damage, which brings our running total to 9. If we look in the decision column, we have now reached the 15% threshold that would warrant treatment. We are greater than or equal to 9. We can now stop scouting. If our number was still 7, we would continue to scout until a decision could be made. You will always have to scout at least 5 groups of 5 plants before a decision can be made. If we look at our graphical field, we have reached the 15% threshold in the corn we scouted. By scouting in a V-shaped pattern, we ensured a representative sample of the entire field. Extrapolating this out to the entire field gives us a good indication of what the entire field may look like had we scouted every individual corn plant. Now that we know that treatment may be necessary, you will need to decide what the best course of action is. To help make this decision, please refer to Cornell's Vegetable Guidelines for Sweet Corn, which can be found at this link. To help you decide on the pesticide that is least harmful to beneficial insects and the environment, please use the EIQ calculator that can be found at this link. To simplify this example, we focused on the worm pests. If, however, you also found other pests, the thresholds are as follows. For in leaf aphids, the threshold is 50% of plants having aphid colonies of 20 individuals or more. For flea beetles, on sweet corn varieties that are susceptible to Stewart's wilt disease, the threshold is 6 flea beetles per 100 plants, or 0.06 beetles per plant. For corn rust, on varieties that are moderately susceptible to rust, the threshold is 80% of leaves infected with rust. Scouting for flea beetles as well as rust should begin when seedlings emerge and should continue through to tasseling. When scouting silking corn, the threshold is much lower at 5%, and you will need to use the associated columns to make a management decision. Scouting will follow the same general pattern. You will sample in a V-shaped pattern, but this time you will look at 5 corn plants that are silking. If one of the 5 consecutive plants is not yet silking, skip it and move to the next plant in the row. You will focus most of your attention on the ear zone, which includes 2 leaves above and 1 leaf below the corn ears. Carefully inspect the silks and ear tips for any sign of damage or larvae. Fill out the form as described for pre-silking corn, but use the lower threshold numbers. Again, refer to the Cornell guidelines for sweet corn, as well as the EIQ calculator when making a management decision. All this information should be used in conjunction with pheromone trap catches to make your final decision. To view the most recent trap catch data, please visit the Sweet Corn Trap Network blog.